And he simply adores those little cheese footballs, don't you, my darling? Oh, isn't he beautiful?
Very attractive little fella. What is it?
He's a little Shih Tzu.
Really? Oh, dear, dear, dear. What breed is it?
Well, they're a lap dogs, aren't they?
A lap dog? Oh, hard to imagine him stalking a reindeer, what?
Major, can I get you another one?
Why not, why not?
Good. For you, Mrs. Chase?
Oh, nothing for me, thank you. But Prince would like a little saucer of warm milk, because it's nearly our bedtime.
Yes, and Manuel? Manuel will attend to its heart's desires. I'm afraid I'm lumbered with the people tonight. Manuel, por favor, el perro microscopico.
Oh, good evening, Dr. Price.
Good evening.
What can I get you?
Scotch, please. And I suppose it's too late to get anything to eat, is it? I missed dinner.
What did you have in mind?
Well, I rather fancy some sausages.
Oh, I'm afraid Chef would have locked them away. We could do you sandwiches, ham, cheese, tomato.
Ham, thank you.
Right, I'll just arrange it for you. Basil!
Stop.
Could you make some ham sandwiches, please?
Look, I'm
Dr. Price.
Oh, of course. Yes, one moment, Doctor. There we are, Major.
Excuse me, Clone.
Found another draft, have we?
We have to be very careful, Mr. Fawlty. He's not very strong.
Indeed, yes. A rapid movement of air could damage him irreparably. If only one could keep him in airtight containers.
He had to breathe, would he, Fawlty?
Well, he could try, Major. He could try. Anything else for you?
No, thank you. No, it's a bit late. We'd better get upstairs.
Quite. Come on, right. Yes. Sorry to have kept you. Doctor, one round, two.
Oh, just one, please.
My pleasure.
No, no, she was the one he had with him the third time. The first one was the dowdy one, then his wife, then her, and now this red. Oh, yes, that must have been lovely. Number 12. Let's see.
Thank you.
How very lovely. Yes, that was them. Not much. They get less fussy as they get older.
Sorry about this.
Please, it couldn't matter less. We're meeting in the morning anyway.
You've had a long journey.
Mm. You get a good night's sleep.
Are you sure you're feeling all right?
Oh, fine, fine. Just a little...
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, you get straight to bed and we'll pick you up here at 9:30.
We'll have a coffee and go into the MD at 10. Fine, thanks, okay.
Right. Good night. Yes. Sleep well.
Good night. Bye.
See you in the morning.
Yes. See you at 9:30. Yeah. Sorry.
Harris? Oh, no, on his own again. Oh, no. I wouldn't have thought so. He watches the football. Number 8, isn't it?
Thank you.
Where are we? Are you feeling all right?
Not too good, no.
Oh, dear. Would you like a little hot something?
Oh, no, no. Fine, thank you.
Oh, well, if there's anything you need.
Yes, thank you.
No, that wasn't him. That was a new one.
Good night. I said good night.
Oh, good night.
Didn't hurt, did it? Good manners cost nothing, girl.
He's not feeling very well, Basil.
You only have to say good night, dear. It's not the Gettysburg Address, is it?
Basil, when you're not feeling well...
Just two little words, dear. Bring a little happiness into the world.
Excuse me.
Yes, Mr. Lehman, what can I do for you?
Do you think I might have breakfast in bed in the morning?
In bed?
Yes.
Of course, Mr. Lehman.
Oh. Yes, we can manage that, can we do
Yes, we can. I'll call you back.
I'm sorry.
Well, most of our guests manage to struggle down in the morning. I wonder if...
a full breakfast or the continental?
Oh, I don't know.
Our chef does a very good full breakfast. Eggs, bacon, sausage, tomato, fried bread.
The continental.
You wouldn't care for kippers?
Oh, fine. Kippers, yes, thank you.
Toast, butter, marmalade.
Yes, thank you.
Tea or coffee?
Yes. Tea, thank you.
A newspaper?
The Telegraph.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Rosewood, mahogany, teak.
I beg your pardon.
What would you like your breakfast tray made out of?
I don't really mind.
Are you sure? Fine. Well, you go along and have a really good night's sleep then. I'm hoping to get a couple of hours later on myself. I'll be up in good time to serve you your breakfast in bed. If you can remember to sleep with your mouth open, you won't even have to wake up. I'll just drop in small pieces of lightly buttered kipper when you're breathing in the right direction, if that doesn't put you out. Ethel?
Sausages, please.
Just sausages?
Mm, just sausages.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee, please.
What is?
Oh, no, not a saucer.
Come on.
I said a bowl.
Hey, boy.
Yes, and not cold like that. That's too cold. I said tepid, didn't I?
Mas grande, Manuel. De agua caliente.
Ah.
Catch pneumonia after that. And bring another cushion. He's not quite high enough.
Sausages on 6, Terry.
Coming out.
Mas grande, Manuel.
Another car strike. Would you believe it?
Put these kippers back, would you, Basil?
They ought to get butlins to run our car factories.
In the fridge.
You should have been eaten by... When was the 6th?
Oh, that's all right.
It says on the packet, Sybil.
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty.
The 6th?
That's just to cover themselves.
Eggs and sausages, Paul.
On the table, on the table. That. Now, put that under him. The cushion, the cushion.
See.
threatened him.
Okay.
You make sudden movements like that, of course he's going to bite. Don't you have dogs in Calcutta?
Excuse me, but I have an order for eggs and sausages for this table.
Oh, yes. The sausages are for him.
Oh.
What's the matter, Manuel?
He bite me.
Cut them up. Cut them up into little pieces. No, not my eggs. Not my eggs. The sausages.
Oh, sorry.
He bite Polly too, you see.
If dogs are allowed in the dining room, at least the staff should know how to handle them.
I'll cut them up in the kitchen, Miss Chase.
Little pieces.
Get this ready.
He hurt you, Polly.
Basil, what are you doing?
Do you know when the six was, Sybil?
Will you just take it upstairs?
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty. Well,
why are you supposed to be that?
Basil, will you just take it up? What's the matter, Mamma? That hairy mosquito just bit us both.
What?
It's not right in dining room like that.
Well, she pays extra for the dog, Manuel, you see. Basil, it's after eight.
Poisoning is still an offence in this country, you know, Sybil.
Oh, do get a move on. We've got a busy day. I've got the laundrymen.
The laundryman? My God, a woman's work is never delegated, is it?
What are you doing, Polly? Just preparing some sausages. Bangers a la bang.
Good morning, breakfast. Breakfast. Here we are. Another car strike marvellous, isn't it? Taxpayers pay millions each year to get the money go on strike. It's called socialism. I mean, if they don't like making cars, why don't they get themselves another bloody job designing cathedrals or composing violin concertos? The British Leyden Concerto in four movements, all of them slow, with a four-hour tea break in between. I'll tell you why. Because they're not interested in anything except lounging about in conveyor belts, stuffing themselves with my money. You don't mind if I turn the light off? Well, enjoy your breakfast. I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. Oh, not at all. Thank you for mentioning it. Unbelievable. Not a single...
You know, it's 5:30 in the morning, so they can lounge around in bed till midday. Do you get so much as a word of thanks? What's that?
Forgot the milk.
Well, don't get talking to him. You never get away.
Would you believe it?
I get him his breakfast, I take it all the way upstairs, I lay it in front of him, hand him his newspaper, I tidy the room, draw the curtains, and guess what he says? I said, guess what he says? Nothing. Your friend, the one in eight, nothing. Not a word. Are you listening? Hello, can anybody hear me? Have I ceased to exist? Have I suddenly become invisible? Sybil, can you see me?
No.
Oh, good, well, I gotta lie down then. No, I won't. I'll go and hit some guests.
Let me go, poor little let me...
Dr. Price's sausages.
What is it, Polly?
He's dead.
Dead? Who? Number eight. Lehman? But Basil just took him his breakfast.
He's cold.
Oh, no.
What's the matter with that dog?
He's dead.
Well, he's certainly struggling for life at the moment. Dead dog in the breakfast room, eh? Egon Rennie'd knock off a star for that.
No, no, Mr. Lehman, dead.
Well, that would explain a lot.
No, Mr. Really? Paul just said so.
What are you on about? I just took him his kippers. Oh, my God.
Wait. I just put the milk down the tray, but I leave. What are you doing? What are you doing?
I told her the 6 week you get 20 years for this.
What?
The kippers, oh my God.
Mr. Fawlty, he's been dead for hours. Mr. Fawlty, he's cold. He's been dead for hours. He must have died in his sleep. Mr. Fawlty.
What?
He hasn't touched those kippers. Well, look. Feel him.
What?
Feel him.
He's stone cold.
Yes.
Oh, joy. Oh, thank you. Oh, isn't it wonderful? I'm so happy. Hooray! Sam, excuse me.
Ah, it's cool.
Bit stuffy, isn't it? I'll open a window.
Who
found the body?
Polly did. I was bringing him up the milk and we'd forgotten it.
You brought the milk with the breakfast?
No, the breakfast was already up.
Well, who brought the breakfast? Who found it?
Oh, I ordered it.
What's that?
That's a bit of it.
A bit of what?
A bit of the breakfast.
You brought him his breakfast?
Yes.
So you told her he was dead?
Yes.
Well, then, why did you bring him... Why did you bring him the milk, then?
Why?
Yes, why?
Well, when he said Mr. Lehman was dead, I thought he said he's still in bed.
Well, he didn't exactly say he was dead, Doctor.
Well, I said he was pretty quiet.
Quiet?
Exactly.
What were you talking to him about, Basil? Car strikes, was it?
Thank you, Sybil.
I don't understand. He's been dead for about 10 hours.
Yes, it's so final, isn't it?
Basil!
Well, wouldn't you say it was final, dear? I'd say it was pretty bloody final.
You mean to tell me you didn't realise this man was dead?
Well, the people don't talk that much anymore. Look, I'm just delivering a tray, right? If the guest isn't singing, "Oh, what a beautiful morning," I don't immediately think, "Oh, there's another one snuffed it in the night, another name in the Forty Towers Book of Remembrance." I mean, this is a hotel, not a Burma railway. Yes, well, I mean, he does actually say hotel outside. I mean, perhaps I should be more specific. Hotel for people who have a better than 50% chance of making it through the night.
What are you looking at me like that for?
Basil, there's a kipper sticking out of your jacket.
Ah, there it is. I've been looking for that. That's the other one.
We'll be downstairs, Doctor. Shall I ring the undertaker? Would you, Polly?
I've been up since 5:30, you know.
He was leaving today. Some people are coming at lunchtime.
Well, we'll put him in another room.
We're full tonight. Oh, do put that away. Get the body into the office until the undertakers come.
Now?
When Doctor's finished.
What are you doing?
Making up his bill.
Who are you going to give it to?
We'll leave it in his wallet. They're bound to look there. Better not charge him for breakfast.
Mr. Simpkins? Forty Towers here. I'm afraid somebody's died during the night. When could you collect the body? Somebody? Anybody, really?
Good morning, good morning.
Oh, you're very careful this morning, Mr. Fawlty.
Yes, well, one of the guests has just died.
You are wicked.
Manuel, we go and get the body. Polly, Polly.
Yes, if you can.
Would it be all right to
move? Can I use the phone, please? I have to call the coroner.
The coroner?
I can't give him his death certificate. I'm not his doctor. I have to report his death to the coroner.
Oh, I see, of course. Do come this way, Doctor.
All clear!
All clear.
It's heavy. Come on.
Good morning, Manuel.
Oh, good morning. Oh, it's all right. Leave it. No, leave it. It's heavy.
Oh, no, it's quite all right. Put them like
that. No, don't bother. We can manage.
Oh, it's no bother.
No, leave it alone.
I know. If I just fold them like
this... Yes, go away. Move, Manuel. Move.
Okay. I'll do it, Miss Tim. No, it's all right. He's dead!
It's all right, Mr.
Shut up, shut up!
Oh, my God!
Slap her, slap her, slap her! She's hysterical, slap her!
Murder!
Slap her!
Murder!
Oh, spiffing. Absolutely spiffing. Well done. Two dead, 25 to go.
Quick, find, find!
There it is! Oh, sorry, I'm in your way.
That's quite all right.
Oh, is this your room?
Yes.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it?
Yes.
Did you enjoy your breakfast?
Oh, yes, thank you, yes. Do you think we could just go inside and get a...
Not really.
Pardon?
Well, it's been cleaned. Mr. Fawlty's doing it.
But we want to get our things.
Yes, we're going out, you see.
Oh, well, it'll only take a couple of minutes.
Well, I'm sorry, we're a little late. Excuse me.
Excuse me. Mr. Fawlty? Mr. Fawlty!
All clear!
Mr. Fawlty! Mr. and Mrs. White want to come into their room.
Oh. Wait a minute!
Hello! Can we come in?
I was just explaining that you were doing the room.
Yes, probably 5 minutes.
Well, couldn't you do it later?
Pick that ash trap, will you, Manuel, please? The big one. Could we do it later?
When we've got our things.
Well, it'll only be a couple of minutes.
Look, Fawlty, we want our things.
Oh, right, yes, thank you so much.
He's locked it.
Oh, well, that's just a precaution.
Have you locked this?
Only slightly.
Will you let us in?
In a minute. Now, get the coats. Get the coats.
What's going on? Well, he's a bit of a perfectionist.
Ready!
What's been going on in here?
Well, we tried rearranging the furniture, but it didn't really work. Manuel has your coats.
Oh.
It's all right, he's from Barcelona.
Oh, what a noise!
Oh, it's just my back.
No, that morning.
Oh, yes, that's all.
No, it's coming from the cupboard.
Well, we'll get some oil. Have a nice day.
There's someone in there.
What?
Yes, listen.
No. No.
Oh, please.
Good Lord, so there is.
Let them out.
Good idea. Right, well, chance to visit the museum.
Open it now, will you?
Oh, all right, yes, right. Oh, it's locked. Oh, damn.
Where's the key?
Yes, sir, where is the key? Do you have any idea, Polly Manuel?
I expect we've left it downstairs somewhere.
Okay. Where's the key?
This is your pocket. No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Oh, well done, Mabel. Thank you very much. Thank you. Right, well, we've got it now. It's all right, all right. I will.
Oh, Miss Tim.
Now, I've warned you about this before. You can hide in your own cupboard, but not in other people's. I'm sorry about this. You can't really blame her. She doesn't have much in her life. She has to make her own entertainment.
She has trouble with her arm. That's why she goes in the cupboard.
Exactly.
Are you feeling better?
Her arm gets stuck there.
It's always happening to her.
He's dead.
This is her husband. She hasn't got over it. Died 30 years ago.
She doesn't mean any arm.
In the cupboard.
No more today. You've had enough. Oh, my God. Look at that. Look. Look. Anything else we can do for you?
What was so horrible, Mrs. Fawlty? You've no idea.
Oh, I know.
It was pitch black in there, and that thing with its hand...
Oh, I know. Now, you have a little rest and try to think of something else.
But anything could have happened.
Well, he was dead, dear.
A man is a man, Mrs. Fawlty.
Oh, I know.
I should speak to him about it.
Speak to him?
To Mr. Fawlty, where his oldest residence.
Well, have a little rest first.
Frightening me like that. I shall speak to him.
Have a word with him in a little while when you're feeling better.
Mm-hmm. I see, yes. Thank you. It's all right, dear. They've got rooms at the Sea View.
Tonight?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look at it.
Yes, and if that's no good, we'll try the one up by the Prophylactic Emporium.
Morning, Fawlty.
Oh, hello, Major.
Any sign of the papers?
Well, you've got it, Major.
Have I? Oh, yes, I have. Oh, I say, Fawlty, he doesn't look quite the ticket.
Well, Major, don't say anything to anybody, but he's dead.
Ah. Shot, was he?
No, died in his sleep.
In his sleep? Ah, well, you're off your guard, you see.
Yes,
right. Oh, Fawlty, I shouldn't let him lie around here, you know.
No, the undertakers are coming to get him.
Ah, because they attract the flies, you see.
Look, I've been waiting in there.
What?
I haven't had any breakfast yet.
Oh, right, sorry. Come in.
It's only sausages.
Mr. Fawlty, I want a word with you, please.
Sorry about the delay, Doctor. Normal service has been resumed as soon as possible. More coffee? Tea? I'll turn the radio down. Oh.
It's Tibbs.
Oh, no.
Would you believe it?
What did you put him there for?
Well, he wouldn't fit the safe and all the drawers were full. Come on, man. Wonderful, isn't it? Our guests, they give us trouble even when they're dead. Come on.
Where are you taking him?
Kitchen.
Polly, just a moment.
Overdone, I'm afraid. Send him down to the crematorium.
Oh, you can't keep a dead body in here where there's food, can we? Of course not.
Oh, right, OK. Sorry, Manuel. Put it in there, in the basket.
Not in here.
What?
Not in the kitchen.
Oh, right. Simmel?
I'm looking after Miss Tibbs, Basil. How are you feeling, dear?
We'll be 2 minutes.
Okay.
Sorry about that, Doctor.
Wash your hands first, please.
Oh, right.
And make sure this area is scrubbed before any more food is prepared in here.
Absolutely.
Sausages accepted. You may cook them immediately. I'll take the risk.
Oh, of course. Too sweet.
Leave it.
No, I take it.
Leave it.
No, it's not time, please. No, please.
I'm sitting here.
It's no lunch till 12.
I'm still having breakfast.
It's finished. All gone, breakfast kaput.
I'm having sausages.
He's not allowed.
Put that back. Look, I'm a doctor. I'm a doctor and I want my sausages.
I tell you, he's finished. Bye-bye, please. Bye-bye.
Now, look.
It's finished.
Give those to me. Come on.
No, it's not possible.
Is everything all right?
He wants to eat now.
I've been trying to sit down and he keeps moving things from my table.
I'm so sorry.
He doesn't seem to understand that I haven't finished breakfast.
Manuel, let me explain. Ah! You understand? Look, I'll be ready in just a couple of minutes.
There we are, Mr. Ingram's number 8. Top of the stairs on the right. Excuse me not coming up with you. One of our guests has been taken ill.
Thank you. Excuse me.
In the office.
Excuse me?
Yes?
We have an appointment with Mr. Lehman. Do you know where he is?
Where he is?
Would he be in the dining room?
Might he be in his room?
Let me think. Where is...
Well, we've come to collect him. Well, we're taking him to... We've come to collect him.
Oh, you've come to collect him?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realise. Modern dress.
What?
Your dress is very modern. I didn't realise women did it.
Did what?
He's downstairs. No, in the basket.
I beg your pardon.
He's in the basket.
In the basket?
Yes.
Hello.
What's he doing in the basket? Well, not much.
What are you talking about?
Well, don't you believe... Look. Oh, my God, he's gone.
Where is he?
Fresh laundry.
They've taken him.
Just hang on a couple of minutes. Sorry to keep you.
It's all right. It's all right. We sorted it out. He's in this one.
Oh. The doctor didn't want him in the kitchen, so we put him in the basket.
It's more hygienic.
Yes, you do work here.
Yes.
Well, we'd like to speak to the manager.
Well, I'm the manager. Is there a problem?
Well, he is, really.
No, there seems to be some kind of misunderstanding here. We've come to collect one of your guests, a Mr. Lehman, to take him into town for a meeting.
Meeting?
Yes, a meeting.
With our managing director. Oh, I see, Mr. Lehman!
Yes. We thought you said the linen.
Brilliant! Sorry, that's it.
Sorry to keep you.
Hello, my sweet.
What are you doing there?
Well, it's a bit involved, but these gentlemen thought that they
had
come...
No, that's not it. No, they were coming for Mr. Lehman, and we thought that they were coming to collect the linen. Mr. Lehman?
Yes, so if you just sort that one out, dear, I'll take the linen upstairs, OK?
I see. Thank you, Basil.
Not at all.
Would you mind coming into the office for a moment?
Another one, Faulty? No, same one, Major. Oh, sorry, come here like that. Sorry.
They've gone into the trap.
In there.
Oh, sorry. Wrong.
Estoy muy cansado. Come on. Is somebody coming?
Mr. Faulty, I no want to work here anymore.
Open the basket! Open the basket! Now, Inside.
Not you. I quit.
Get out.
I'll strike.
I'm warning you.
I stay here. It's nice.
You see this? You're next.
Really, I'm so sorry. Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye.
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 Goodbye. Yes? Could I get my hat? Your hat? Yes. It's just there.
Yes, I'll have it sent on.
What? Do you have a card with your address? I'll send it on.
Well, could I just get it?
Well, but do you have to have it now?
Well, yes.
Well, suppose if you lose it? I mean, it's windy today.
I'd like to have it.
Oh, right. Manuel! Manuel! He's in the basket. Polly, would you get Manuel out of the basket, please?
Manuel?
Yes, come on, girl, come on. What's the matter?
Well, he isn't in there.
Yes, he is.
He isn't.
He is. Look for him.
Oh, sorry.
You big scab. See? Manuel, would you get this gentleman his hat, please?
Where?
There, on the rack. Sorry, what colour was it?
Brown.
Brown.
No, that's not it.
No.
Thank you.
Mr. Faulty, I want a word with you in your office.
Yes, when would be convenient for you?
I'm 79.
What on earth is going on here?
Oh, sorry about the eiderdown. It got a bit caught.
My baby's dying. They poisoned him.
Your baby?
Sybil.
He said he'd call for a vet.
A vet?
Sybil.
I've just cooked these sausages myself and they're off. They should have been eaten by the fur.
Ah, there you are, dear. You do look nice. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. Laundry's ready. Ladies and gentlemen, there have been a lot of cock-ups this morning. You all deserve an explanation, and I'm happy to say that my wife will give it to you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
I would like to make it to you.
What's going on, old boy?
Basil! 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 Cheese footballs, don't you, my darling? Oh, isn't he beautiful?
Very attractive little fella. What is it?
He's a little shih tzu.
Is he really? Oh, dear, dear, dear. What breed is it?
Well, they're a lap dogs, aren't they?
A lap dog? Oh, how hard to imagine him stalking a reindeer, what?
Major, can I get you another one?
Why not, why not?
Good. For you, Mrs. Chase?
Oh, nothing for me, thank you. But Prince would like a little saucer of warm milk, because it's nearly our bedtime.
Yes, Manuel will attend to its heart's desires. I'm afraid I'm lumbered with the people tonight. Manuel, por favor, el perro microscopico.
Oh, good evening, Dr. Price.
Good evening.
What can I get you?
Scotch, please. And I suppose it's too late to get me to eat, is it? I missed dinner.
What did you have in mind?
Well, I rather fancy some sausages.
Oh, I'm afraid Chef would have knocked them away. We could do you sandwiches, ham, cheese, tomato.
Ham, thank you.
Right, I'll just arrange it for you. Basil!
Stop.
Could you make some ham sandwiches, please?
Look, I'm
Dr. Price.
Oh, of course. Yes, one moment, Doctor.
Here we are, Major.
Excuse me, Clone.
Found another draft, have we?
We have to be very careful, Mr. Faulty. He's not very strong.
Indeed, yes. A rapid movement of air could damage him irreparably. If only one could keep him in airtight containers.
He wouldn't be able to breathe, would he, Faulty?
Well, he could try, Major. He could try. Anything else for you?
No, thank you. No, it's a bit late. We'd better get upstairs.
Quite. Come on, right. Sorry to have kept you. Doctor, one round, two.
Oh, just one, please.
My pleasure.
No, no. She was the one he had with him the third time. The first one was the dowdy one, then his wife, then her, and now this red. Oh, yes, that must have been lovely. Number 12. Let's see.
Thank you.
How very lovely. Yes, that was them. Not much. They get less fussy as they get older.
Sorry about this.
Please, it couldn't matter less. We're meeting in the morning anyway.
You've had a long journey.
Mm. You get a good night's sleep.
Are you sure you're feeling all right?
Oh, fine, fine. Just a little...
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, you get straight to bed and we'll pick you up here at 9:30.
We'll have a coffee and go into the MD at 10.
Fine, thanks, okay. Right.
Good night.
Yes. Sleep well.
Good night.
Bye. See you in the morning.
Yes. See you at 9:30. Sorry.
Harris? Oh, no, on his own again. Oh, no. I wouldn't have thought so. He watches the football. Number 8, isn't
Thank
it?
Thank you.
Where are we? Are you feeling all right?
Not too good, no.
Oh, dear. Would you like a little hot something?
Oh, no. Fine, thank you.
Oh, well, if there's anything you need.
Yes, thank you.
No, that wasn't him. That was a new one.
Good night. I said good night.
Oh, good night.
Didn't hurt, did it? Good manners cost nothing, girl.
He's not feeling very well, Basil.
You only have to say good night, dear. It's not the Gettysburg Address, is it?
Basil, when you're not feeling well...
Just two little words, dear. Bring a little happiness into the world.
Excuse me.
Yes, Mr. Lehman, what can I do for you?
Do you think I might have breakfast in bed in the morning?
In bed?
Yes.
Of course, Mr. Lehman.
Oh. Yes, we can manage that, can we do
Yes, we can. I'll call you back.
I'm sorry. Well, most of our guests manage to struggle down in the morning. I wonder if...
A full breakfast or the continental?
Oh, I don't know.
Our chef does a very good full breakfast. Eggs, bacon, sausage, tomato, fried bread.
The continental.
You wouldn't care for kippers?
Oh, fine. Kippers, yes, thank you.
Toast, butter, marmalade.
Yes, thank you.
Tea or coffee?
Yes. Tea, thank you.
A newspaper?
The Telegraph.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Rosewood, mahogany, teak.
I beg your pardon.
What would you like your breakfast tray made out of?
I don't really mind.
Are you sure? Fine. Well, you go along and have a really good night's sleep then. I'm hoping to get a couple of hours later on myself. I'll be up in good time to serve you your breakfast in bed. If you can remember to sleep with your mouth open, you won't even have to wake up. I'll just drop in small pieces of lightly buttered kipper when you're breathing in the right direction, if that doesn't put you out. Ethel? Sausages, please.
Just sausages?
Mm, just sausages.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee, please.
But he's...
No, not a saucer.
Come
on. I said a bowl.
Hey, boy.
Yes, and not cold like that. That's too cold. I said tepid, didn't I?
Mas grande, Manuel. De agua caliente.
Ah.
Catch pneumonia from that. And bring another cushion. He's not quite high enough.
Sausages on 6, Terry.
Coming up.
Mas grande, Manuel.
Another car strike. Would you believe it?
Put these kippers back, would you, Basil?
They ought to get the butlins to run our car factories.
In the fridge.
You should have been eaten by... When was the 6th?
Oh, that's all right.
It says on the packet, Sybil.
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty.
The 6th?
That's just to cover themselves.
Eggs and sausages, Paul.
On the table, on the table. No. That. Now, put that under him. The cushion, the cushion.
See.
He bit me.
You frightened him.
Okay.
You make sudden movements like that, of course he's going to bite. Don't you have dogs in Calcutta?
Excuse me, but I have an order for eggs and sausages for this table.
Oh, yes. The sausages are for him.
Oh.
What's the matter, Manuel?
He bite me.
Cut them up into little pieces. No, not my eggs, the sausages.
Oh, sorry.
He might pull it too, you see.
Look, if dogs are allowed in the dining room, at least the staff should know how to handle them.
I'll cut them up in the kitchen, Miss Chase.
Little pieces.
Get us ready.
He hurt you, Polly.
Basil, what are you doing?
Do you know when the 6th was, Sybil?
Will you just take it upstairs?
They're all right, Mr. Fawlty.
Well, where are you supposed to be that?
Basil, will you just take it up? What's the matter, Mamma? That hairy mosquito just bit us both.
What?
It's not right in dining room like that.
Well, she pays extra for the dog, Manuel, you see. Basil, it's after 8.
Poisoning is still an offence in this country, you know, Sybil.
Oh, do get a move on. We've got a busy day. I've got the laundryman.
The laundryman? My God, a woman's work is never delegated, is it?
What are you doing, Polly?
Just preparing some sausages. Bangers a la bang.
Good morning, breakfast. Breakfast. Here we are.
another caste like Marv, isn't it? Taxpayers pay millions each year, they get the money, go on strike. It's called socialism. I mean, if they don't like making cars, why don't they get themselves another bloody job designing cathedrals or composing violin concertos? The British Leyden Concerto in four movements, all of them slow, with a four-hour tea break in between. I'll tell you why. Because they're not interested in anything except lounging about in conveyor belts, stuffing themselves with my money. You don't mind if I turn the light off? Well, enjoy your breakfast. I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. Oh, not at all. Thank you for mentioning it.
Unbelievable. Not a single bloody word.
You know, it's 5:30 in the morning, so they can lounge around in bed till midday. Do you get so much as a word of thanks? What's that?
Forgot the milk.
Well, don't get talking to him. You never get away.
Would you believe it?
I get him his breakfast, I take it all the way upstairs, I lay it in front of him, hand him his newspaper, I tidy the room, draw the curtains, and guess what he says? I said, guess what he says? Nothing. Your friend, the one in eight, nothing. Not a word. Are you listening? Hello, can anybody hear me? Have I ceased to exist? Have I suddenly become invisible? Sybil, can you see me?
No.
Oh, good, well, I go and lie down then. No, I won't. I'll go and hit some guests.
Poor little tummock, rummock, oh, let me...
Dr. Price's sausages.
What is it, Polly?
He's dead.
Dead? Who?
Number eight.